I greet you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Today I want to talk about the 25 tips of wisdom in marriage. 25 tips of wisdom in marriage. I want to talk about wisdom in marriage. Proverbs 14 from verse 1 to 3. The wise woman builds a house, but the foolish pulls it down with their hands. He who walks in his upright fears the Lord, but he who is perverse in his ways despises him. In the mouth of a fool it's a rod of pride, but the lips of the wise will preserve them. The lips of the wise will preserve them. Here it says, a wise woman build a house with her own hands, but a fool pulls it down with their hands. So, which means the way you behave in your marriage, it causes problem. The way you behave in your marriage, it builds your marriage. So, even long marriage, 20 years in marriage, 40 years in marriage, 30 years in marriage, people, they are divorcing because they lack wisdom. If you lack wisdom, which means you don't have a knowledge about what you are doing, at such time, people with 5 children, they are divorcing because they lack knowledge. So you need wisdom. Let be your foundation of marriage be Jesus. Your foundation of your marriage, let it be Jesus. A lot of people, they lack wisdom. If you lack wisdom, a lot of problems will come. So you need wisdom to apply knowledge of marriage. Number one, whenever you see couple fighting, they lack wisdom. People, they fight. That maybe you can listen to me. Maybe you can understand to me. Maybe you cannot be impolite to me. People are fighting. Is it the way of resolving conflicts? You sit down in a dialogue, then you sit down, then wherever you know that you are wrong, then you accept that I am wrong. Wherever you know that you are supposed to apologize, apologize. Don't be an advocate or a lawyer in marriage to prove yourself that you, if you are wrong, you want to prove yourself that I am not wrong, but you are wrong. That is arrogance. So people, they fight because they lack knowledge. One is not humble himself or herself. There's a war of words. That is the main thing you see people fighting. So no good ways to use clean language, beautiful language in your marriage. Stop fighting. Fighting does not help, but sit down. Wherever you know that you are wrong, you know, people, they always make mistakes. We always make mistakes. We all make mistakes, but we must forgive each other. Don't say, I'm sick and tired of you. You see now. War of words is the main problem, or the action, whatever action you are doing which irritates your opposite sex, your partner. So be very careful with your words, with your mouth. Avoid fighting. Learn to listen or to just keep quiet to avoid problems. People of God, they don't do that. If you see that, it's better to ask for a prayer. Let's pray. Number two, become a child of God to have wisdom of God in your marriage. Become a child of God to have wisdom of God. There are people who are born again, but they've got problem in their marriages. But they are born again, a husband and a wife. They are born again. What is lacking there? It's understanding and wisdom. You must know how to solve your problem. God must be your foundation. Use the word of God. Let the Holy Spirit of God lead you. Don't do what you feel. Don't do what you want. If you say, I can do what I want, whenever I want, which is Satan. That is wrong. That is wrong. That is wrong. When God is your foundation, everything is going to be good. Because you know what God wants. God doesn't want people who have got unforgiving spirit, you've got bitterness in your marriage, resentment, because of the words or whatever is happening in your marriage, problems which you are facing. And somewhere, before you ask someone for a problem, ask yourself, do I have a problem? Correct your problem first than to correct someone's problem. The Bible said, how can you see someone's eye is a problem in someone's eye, but inside you, it is there also. Your eye has got a problem also. Number three, lack of respect. You lack wisdom. If you lack respect, a lot of people, they respect the pastor. They respect doctor if they have got a prescription. This is an assignment from God. A man need a respect. A man, all men, they need the respect. If you show him that you are respecting him, he will feel happy. If you show him that you are not respecting him, that's where the problem comes. A lot of argument. If you see that you are reducing him, that's where the problem comes. So respect is very important in your marriage. Respect is very important in your marriage. Respect one another. How do you respect your husband? How do you respect your wife? Either they kneel down, you see, either they don't kneel down, they kneel down to a pastor. Are you married to a pastor? You respect pastor more than your husband. Are you married to a pastor? It's not bad to respect a pastor, but we are saying respect your husband first. What did Sarah say to Abraham? She said, Lord, to Abraham. So, as long as you are boasting yourself that I can't respect you. So, most of the problems caused because you lack wisdom, knowledge. Seek it, knowledge. Peace is in your home, but you need to correct your characters first. Peace is there. You have got it in your heart. You have got it in your heart. Your husband have got peace. Your wife have got peace. So you must work out your character to solve all problems, which means you must work out your character. Yes. Number four, know how to treat your husband. Know how to treat your husband or your wife. So if you don't know how to treat him, it's a problem. He must feel welcome at home. He must feel welcome at home. Always accusing each other. Arguments, which is bad. So know how to treat each other. He must feel at home. Or he mustn't say to organize a Jane going somewhere else to avoid talkative. Don't be talkative, ladies. Don't be talkative. All men, if they see that you are talkative, they avoid you. And you say, I want time with my husband. But he is avoiding you. You don't know how to talk. You are a very rude person. So be teachable. Be teachable. Be teachable. So number five, remain in love with God. A lot of people, when they face problem, they don't remain in love with Christ. They don't remain in love with Christ. Christ is our answer. Christ is our solution. Who is your solution? Don't use a fresh power your fresh power or your carnal mind. Somewhere you need Jesus to help you. Maybe you sit down, but your husband doesn't like to change, your wife doesn't like to change, which is a great problem. It's a great problem. You need Jesus for intervention in your marriage. You need Jesus to intervene in your marriage. You need Jesus to help you. And God is not the author of confusion. God is not the author of confusion. But Satan caused confusion, separation in marriages, causes problems, different problems, is fighting people. Number six, pride. That one is the greatest thing in marriage. You don't want to be corrected. And you say you will never be corrected because you say, I know everything. Pride is a very, 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 very big disease in marriage. Because you say, don't tell me or don't correct me, especially if they are husbands. They say, I know everything. The Bible said you must under me. Remember, your wife is your helper. It's your helper, not your slave. And you see, that's a big problem. So beware of pride. Or if it is delayed, they say, my beauty. I'm so beautiful. You see, I've got a good body structure. That's a pride. I'm still very young. I can go and marry again. You see, it's a big problem, that one. That's a part of pride. If you are beauty, you are beautiful yourself. You must be beauty in heart. It doesn't, outside the appearance, it helps nothing in marriage. But your character helps in marriage. Your character helps in marriage. Your character helps in marriage. And you take yourself as you are, is very special. Or you are coming from a wealth family, a rich family. A family who have got a wealthy. And you say you are poor to mention, to point your wife or your husband that we come from where they, we come from a rich family. That is pride. Why can't you build your own life? Those people who say they are rich, they build their own life. Or don't say you are not educated. I'm highly educated. Accusing each other, which is bad. Children of God do not do that. Children of God do not do that. So avoid pride. Whenever your husband or your wife is talking to you, then you try to avoid, try to have dialogue. Then you try to avoid. That's a pride. To solve problem, you sit down. Then you discuss the problem. Then you accept. If you don't accept that, you are wrong, which means it's pride. You have got pride. Number seven, don't take problems to your in-laws, problems to your in-laws. When they see your husband or your wife, they won't respect, because what comes in their mind, it comes that problem which you told them. It's not all friends again which you must tell problems. Or whatever happening in your home, then you call your mother, you text your mother, you text your auntie, you text your brother. Don't do that. Be mature. Try to solve problem yourself. Try to solve your marital problem yourself. It's not all friends who must know you. That's why you see a lot of people, you say, my friend took my wife. Why? Because he was telling him his problem. It's not all friends who are bad. They are good friends who can build you. They are bad friends also. You must have a person you respect. Find a respected person who can correct you, who can solve your problems, your conflicts. Find a good person who can help you to find your problem, who can be a fault finder and who can help you, and you can move on with your life. So don't behave like children. Don't behave like children. Engage power of faith, which is Jesus. Pray together. Pray together. Fast together. Engage power of faith. Pray together. Where you missed it, you need mercy. If you don't pray together, it's a problem. One will be demonized, one will be free. So pray together. Sexual needs. You know, I'm not going to read it. 1 Corinthians 7, verse 3 to 5. It says, a wife, you do not have a power to your body. If you are a woman, you don't have a power to your body. Only your husband has got your power. And you now there's a problem that you are avoiding your husband. Do what your husband wants. If you don't do that, you are causing him to sneak away. Girlfriends, why? There are women who are ready to do what you are not doing. There are women who are outside there, who know how to please men. I'm saying this. So be ready to please your husband in your bedroom, to satisfy him. Even asking him, are you satisfied? Ask him, are you satisfied? Surprise him. Yes, surprise him with sex. A lot of men you see all over the world, they like sex. But most of women, they don't like it. You see now, that's where the problem comes. That's where the problem comes. And you say, you don't know how to do it. You don't know how to do it for me. Which is bad. Which is bad. How can you say so, that you don't know how to do it? So it will avoid small house. If you don't satisfy him in at sex, it will cause problem. And you go back to God again and say, God, help me. This husband is cheating me. But you are the problem. You are not satisfying him. Satisfy him. Let him not complain about sex. Let him not complain about sex. Or men, they can do it. I'm tired. Don't touch me. I'm tired. I'm from work. Don't touch me. You want a woman who must touch you? Who must touch your husband? Who must touch you? Or your wife? Or your wife, you can say, I'm tired of work. And, or maybe you can lie that you are sick, but it's only you are tired, or you don't want to see a man around you, which is bad. Which is bad. You don't want to see a man around you because you are bored with something, or you are tired. Just when you are bored with someone, don't involve your conflicts with the people in your marriage. When you come home, just do what you're supposed to do to please your husband. How do you feel if you see your husband is unhappy? If you see your wife unhappy? Sometimes they may say, it's better I will find a girlfriend or a second wife. Why they use those languages? It's not good for a born again to use those languages. Maybe they can say, you can think better. You can think better, or you can... you can do better thing. So be close to your partner and intimacy. Be close in your partner and intimacy. Don't swallow everything. Wherever you are not satisfied, tell him. Ask yourself. Ask yourself, your husband, are you satisfied with the sex? Are you satisfied, your wife? Ask your wife, are you satisfied? You must satisfy each other. That's where a lot of problems are coming there. Because the men are going out because he's not satisfied. You are limiting him. Always you complain too much, which is bad. Which is bad. Which is bad. It's not good. Number 10. Rebelling against your husband damages the future. You are threatening each other in front of children. You are rebelling him, reducing him in front of children, or telling your children that this man is not good in front of your children. Telling children, feeding children wrong information. Or you say, your father beat me, which is not good. Why do you fight in front of children? Don't fight in front of children, which is bad. Don't fight in front of your children, which is bad. You damage the future of your children. They will think that marriage is bad. When whatever you are doing, don't do that. Number 11, don't cause division in marriage. Don't cause division, especially for you and your children. Then you cause division because you have got misunderstanding, especially mother. Children, they listen to mother too much than their father because always they have mother. So don't cause division. Whenever you have problem, just solve it yourself, two of you, and let children not know. When you have problem, go in bedroom and sit down. Go in bedroom and sit down. You start to shout each other in front of children. That is disrespecting your children, and you are feeding them with the wrong information. They will think that marriage is not a good thing. But you, mother and father, there's someone who is wrong there. There's someone who is wrong there. Number 12. If you want a happy marriage, understand each other. Don't be stubborn. If you want a happy marriage, understand each other. If you want a happy marriage, understand each other. You must understand your husband, understand your wife, the weaknesses. And you lift her weaknesses and take her weakness and show her weakness. Tell her in love. Tell her in love. And use all types of communication or all forms of communication. It might be verbal or non-verbal. Use it. Use it. It helps you. Because if you don't do this, it is going to take your happiness. It is going to take your happiness. Number 13. Forgive one another. Forgive one another. Reply. You take things of last year, 2 years ago, when you were married, when you were a boy and a girl, then you still have that in your mind, in your heart. Forgive one another. Forgive one another. Do you forgive him? Jesus said, Peter asked Jesus, how often do I forgive? Do I forgive? Is it per day or seven per day or what? Jesus said to Peter, 7 times 70. You must forgive 7 times 70. If you don't forgive, you are killing yourself because you have bitterness. At the end of the day, you see a lot of people, they've got depression. Because of unforgiving spirit, a lot of people, they've got a lot of problems. Because you'll be in a prison yourself. You'll be in a prison yourself. Matthew 18 verse 20, you go up with it. It will talk about forgiveness. Submission. This verse, I will read it. A lot of people, they submit themselves to doctor. When doctor said something, they respect that the doctor says so. But to your husband, you don't forgive, you don't submit it. 1 Peter 3 verse 5. 1 Peter 3 verse 5. For in this manner in former times, the holy woman who trusted in God also adorned themselves, being submissive to their own husband. To submissive to their own husband, not to pastor or bishop. You submit yourself and you show that you are very respectful. But when you go home, you don't do that. When we say submit yourself, if you ask 50-50, like the government of nowadays, they don't have God. Because they say it's now 50-50. Yes, they say it's now 50-50 because you say, I'm going to work. That's why you see a lot of divorce in marriages. Because someone lack submission. Someone lack submission. So, here it says, as Sarah obey Abraham, calling you Lord, whose daughters you are, if you do good and are not afraid with any terror. Husband, likewise, dwell them with understanding, giving honor to the wife as to weaker vessel, and as being heirs together of grace to life, that your prayers may not be hindered. So, dwell with your wife with understanding. Do well with your wife with understanding. You might pray if you have got a misunderstanding, which means your prayer is going to be hindered. And you know that your wife is a weaker vessel. All men, you must know this. So a lot of divorces is caused because of someone lacked submission. You want to challenge your husband. You want to be on top of your husband, which is a big problem. If you say you want to be married, submit yourself. That is not abusing. That is from God. Because God said to Eve, all your will be to Adam, or whatever your needs, it will be under Adam. This is from God, and you can't fight with God. You submit yourself to doctors, lawyers, which is bad. Number 15, enjoy your wife, enjoy your children, which means your wife must enjoy it, which means enjoy your, how do you enjoy it? Give one another time to be together. Going out with your children, you must have time with your wife. If you are nearest beaches, you go there. Yes, and you just relax yourself and with your children, and they must know their father. Enjoy it. Let us enjoy each other and see that. Tell your husband, ask your husband, where are you not happy? If you are stubborn and not audit, you must audit each other and ask each other, where are you not happy, my husband? Where are you not happy, my wife? You must be open. Don't swallow everything, or don't just say it's fine. A person who say everything is fine, it's a dangerous person. It's a dangerous person. Number 16, selfish in marriage. Don't be selfish in marriage. Yes, don't be selfish. You just say, this is mine, this is my car. You can't touch this. You see, this is from me. This is the cup of father. It was for all the time. You see, this is for father. This is for mother. Although you are saying it for children, they must respect your property also, yes. And it's their property also. But don't be selfish. That's why you see someone, your wife doesn't know your pay. Your wife doesn't know your pay. Each and everyone have got his own bank account. That's being selfish. If you are in marriage, you are one, and everything you put it on table. You put it on table. Money is always a problem. People, they are disrespecting each other because of money. Marriage, they are being people, they are being divorced because of money. Number 17, there is things to pray and things need counseling. There are things which you can pray for, and there are things which need counseling. There are things which you must talk and discuss about it, and sit down about it, and discuss about it, Then, where you need counseling, you must need counseling. Pray after counseling, or sit down and discuss the problem. You say, God, remember my marriage. When you are in marriage, then when you are in practical, you are doing opposite thing. Then when you go to for prayer, God, remember my marriage. After all, you do opposite thing, which is bad. Which is bad. If you say you want to be married, do correct things. There are things which you must sit down. There are things which you are not supposed to pray. Especially there's misunderstanding. You don't just go to prayer. You must sit down and say, I'm unhappy there. You must welcome each other. You must welcome each other. Then you show it. Yes, you show it. So the Bible said, love your wife as Jesus loved the church. The Bible says, love your wife as Jesus loved the church. A power of ignorance destroys the marriage. If you ignore what you know, that you are supposed to do it, then you just ignore it to live your duties as a father. It destroys. Do you know as a father what you must do? A wife, you know what you must do as a mother. A mother He must know that he must satisfy your husband's needs. Your husband must be a first priority. Must be a first priority, your husband, to know that he is happy. If it is not like that, you are there in marriage because of your husband. And children, they need their love also. You won't mix it. Father, he needs his love. Children, they need their love. So you can't mix it. So you must create time for each other. You must create time for each other. If you don't do that, which means it's a big problem. Which means it's a big problem. You lack wisdom. This, remember, we are talking of wisdom. Words of wisdom. Don't be ignorant. It's a anti-marriage spirit. That what you know, you are supposed to do it, then you don't do it. That's a big problem. Number 19. If you want a change in life, be teachable. If you have got arrogance, yeah, it's a problem. If you can't be teachable, it's a problem. The first thing, you must listen to each other. Listen. Learn to listen. If you don't listen, you are not teachable. A teachable person, when you tell him something is wrong, he will listen. And if you are not teachable, you won't listen to anyone else. You think that you will have a pride. If you don't have a teachable spirit, we have a teachable spirit. Whenever you hear that you are wrong, be teachable. When you are teachable, don't say words which are reducing him. No, nothing you can tell me. Oh, and also, you are wrong also. You are wrong also. That is not teachable. If you are teachable, let's focus with what is on ground there. If you know that whenever you see that I'm wrong, just tell me that time. Don't wait for a problem to rise, then you tell me also that day. That's arrogance. Yes, that's arrogance. Be teachable. Number 20, everyone want to be appreciated. Appreciate your wife, appreciate your husband. Whatever you see, it's good. Just appreciate it. If you don't appreciate it, it's a big problem. You are giving him money, you must say thank you, buy something for you. Appreciate it. Appreciate, learn to appreciate, praise each other. To motivate each other, learn to appreciate each other. Learn to appreciate each other. Number 21, be romantic. A lot of husbands, they just say when they've got their own feeling, they just want to satisfy themselves. You know, a lot of ladies, they are complaining in their homes and say, yo, husband are too much. You know, a lot of husbands, they don't go for teaching. Only women, they go to church for a teaching. But a lot of husbands, they don't want, but they don't have information. They are not romantic. You know, you don't wash your teeth. You are smelling, but you ask for a kiss, which is bad. You must brush your teeth first. Yes, be romantic. And don't be happy in bedroom always. When you are not out of bedroom, you are serious, you are rude, which is bad. Be social. And be a happy family. When you are in bedroom, you start to be happy because you know that you want sex, which is bad. Be very careful for that thing. Be very careful for that thing. So be romantic. Number 22. Know how to treat your partner to feel at home. Know how to feel your partner. How to treat your partner to feel at home. You know, if you don't do that, it's a big problem. You must feel at home. You mustn't create germs. You must not create germs. So, know how to treat each other. Must feel at home, that he will miss home. Or he can't come home at late. Only it is a sleeping time because you don't want problems. You don't want problems. That's why you see someone, he preferable, a newspaper, a preferable, a television. You see now. You see, that's a problem. Or you go and sleep earlier. So, have wisdom. We are talking of wisdom. Number 23. get understanding, be an understandable person. You understand through listening. That's why the Bible says, dwell with your wife in understanding. With understanding. With understanding. You must understand each other. Learn your husband. Learn your wife. What he wants. Yeah. Be understandable. Jesus must, number 24, Jesus must be your foundation. Jesus must be your foundation. Who is your foundation? If he is not your foundation, it's very, very difficult to stay at, or to live a life of restraintment, which is bad. So Jesus must be your foundation. Number 25, understand the communication skills. Understand the communication skills. You must have the communication skills. There are things which can hinder us in communication. They're like moods. Don't talk with moods. Understand. Understand with all types of communication. Try by all means. But not one person is putting effort. One is not putting effort. You must have everything. You must communicate. Don't just do your own things yourself. Don't do your own things yourself. Communicate. Communication. Yes, communication is good. If you do your own things, you say, I'm doing my own thing, which is bad. So be very careful with what you are doing. Thank you so much. Have wisdom in your marriage. This is words of wisdom in your marriage. If you keep it, you will see your marriage is moving. Thank you so much. Stay blessed in Jesus' mighty name. Don't forget to subscribe for more teachings. Thank you. Thank you.